In this video, I'm going to talk about peer reviews. First, I'm going to explain what peer reviews are. Then I'm going to talk about the benefits of implementing peer reviews for your project. And finally, I'm going to give a demo of how you can do peer reviews for your project using GitHub. Okay, so what are peer reviews? Peer reviews is a technique used in programming to improve the quality of the code. The way that it works is every single change that's done on the code base for the project gets reviewed by another developer. So if you commit any changes like a bug fix or a new feature, then another developer will look through that code and see if they can find any bugs or improvements that could be made. There are so many benefits of using peer reviews. I find it extremely beneficial to use peer reviews in a project, and it really does improve the quality of the code. The three main benefits of peer reviews are, number one, it improves the quality of the code and reduces bugs that you get put into production. The way that it does this is every single change is reviewed by someone else, and in my experience, when using peer reviews, in pretty much every single review, there's at least one bug fix or one feature that's detected in the peer review. That means in every single change that would have been made, those bugs and those bug fixes would have been put into the main source code. So it really does improve the quality of the code. The second benefit of it is it helps you to learn from other developers. And it also helps other developers to learn from you. Because you're looking at other people's code and you're looking at how they approach different problems, you're gaining valuable experience into alternative ways to do things. And it's the same goes for the other developer as well. So if you're submitting a review for someone else, then you might explain in that review a better or improved way of doing what they're doing that they may not have known about before. If you're getting your work reviewed, then someone else can tell you how you could improve on the code and make it better. And this is all valuable learning experience. The third benefit of doing peer reviews is knowledge transfer within the team. So if you're working in a development team, one of the problems that can occur is that one developer only knows about one particular component of the project. The problem with this is if that developer is ever off sick or if they're overworked with anything or they leave the team, then that knowledge is lost within the team. Peer reviews help knowledge transfer because it means that other people have looked at the code so they understand what is going on. And this really improves the efficiency within the team. Okay, so now I'm going to give you a quick demo of how you can use peer reviews in your project using GitHub. If you don't use GitHub, then other Git platforms like Bitbucket and GitLab support the same kind of features, so you can pretty much do it no matter which one you're using. All right, so let's get started. So I have a sample project that I'm going to use to demonstrate how you would do peer reviews in a working environment. So I have this demo peer reviews project, and what you would do is you would be assigned a particular bug fix or a change that you would need to make to the code. So my change is just going to be, I'm going to tidy up this title here, and I'm going to add an extra developer section. So just like you would in any other Git project, I'm going to clone the code to my local machine. All right, and now I'm going to change into that directory. And I'm going to check out the develop branch. Now, this really depends on the different policies that you have in the company that you're working for, but it's generally good practice to have a master branch with the production version of the code and then a develop branch which has all of the development changes that are currently in progress. So I'm going to do git checkout develop. Now the develop branch is already created. If your project doesn't already have a develop branch, then you just need to create that first. And then what you would do for peer reviews is you would create a feature branch off this develop branch. So I'm going to create a feature branch, and typically you would, if you're using something like Gitflow, the branch would be feature / the name of the change or the feature that you're implementing. Or you might even use the Jira ticket number or something to keep track of it. So I'm going to do git checkout B because I'm going to create a new branch. And we're going to call this update readme. This is basically the change that I'm going to make. All right, so now I'm working on the feature branch update README. I can open the code in my Atom editor and make the change. All right, so I have the code open in Atom and it's already opened the README file by default. So I'm gonna just change it. I'm just gonna type demo peer reviews. And I'm gonna add an extra development section here. All right, so now I'm gonna save that change. And then just like any other change, you just commit that to the branch. So do git commit. And I'm gonna type the change, updated README, exit and save. All right, now I've done the change, I'm gonna push this branch up to I'm gonna push this branch back to GitHub. So it gives me the instructions here. I'm just gonna copy that. All right, so now it's pushed to GitHub. Now I can go ahead and create a pull request. And the pull request is what you would use to have your peer review approved. I have two different GitHub accounts signed in here just to demonstrate this. So I'm currently working off this London App Dev account, and I'm gonna request a peer review from the London App Dev 2 account that I have that is also in the GitHub, same GitHub organization that I've committed this code to. Okay, so from my account, the original account that I'm making the changes under, if I refresh this, well, you can see here that it's detected that the new branch was pushed here 1 minute ago. So if you click on that, it'll take you to the new branch. All right, so you can see that my changes have been implemented here. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a new pull request. So in this pull request, you can write an explanation of the changes that you made. Now, you've got to remember to update this to the develop branch, because ideally you want to be merging your changes into the develop branch, and then from the develop branch, you'll merge them into the master branch when you're ready to do a release. All right, so it's defaulted the title with update README, which is the git commit comment that I put in there. And you could put a note here just saying, hi, please, could you review my changes? All right, and then you wanna request a reviewer. So if you click request reviewer, then it will give you a list of all the people that are in the current GitHub organization. So you choose the person that you want to review, and you can add more than one reviewer. Now with peer reviews, typically you would just ask for one reviewer, but you may want to add a different reviewer if there's different components to the project that another person knows about, or you just want to have someone else have a look at the code just for their experience, just for them to understand how it's working. All right, so now that I've selected the reviewers and I've added some details here, I'm going to click create pull request. And then it goes ahead and creates the pull request. Now, if I minimize this and go over to the other GitHub account, so if you pretend that this is another person who's working on the project, then I should have a notification that says they've requested a review, or at least it will say within the project. It sends you an email to the account when they've been added as a reviewer and that there's someone is waiting for a review. This is the wrong project. I want to go to the correct organization here. So the London App Developer Organization. And here you go. You can see here that London App Dev opened pull request. And if I click that, it will take me to the pull request. And they've asked for a review and it's my account here. So I can then go ahead and add a review to this. All right, so if I go to files changed here, And then it will give me a list of all the files that have been changed in this feature branch. All right, so you can see, you can take a look through here and you can get a comparison of all the different changes. So you can see that they've added, they've removed this title, they've added a new title, and they've added this section here. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is click on review changes, and then you can leave your feedback. So you can say whether you think there could be an improvement made, or if you found a bug, or if you found a typo or anything. And you can actually click on a specific line that's been changed, and you can add an inline comment here, and you can just say, oh, I found a typo, or I found an issue with this line, and you can write the explanation in the comments here. All right, so this all looks good, so I'm just gonna approve this pull request and click submit. And now if you go back to the other account, they should have got a notification via email to say that the pull request has been submitted and has been approved by the person. Now, you can now merge this pull request. So now that it's been approved, you can go ahead and merge the changes in automatically in GitHub. It really depends on the process you want to implement in your project. In some projects, you have the peer reviewer merge the changes when they're done. And in other projects, you have the original developer merge the changes. I like to do it with the original developer just in case there's any merge conflicts or anything like that. So I'm gonna do confirm merge. And there you go. You can now delete the branch to clean it up. And the changes have been peer reviewed and merged into the developer branch. So that's how you would use peer reviews in the project. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, then please leave them in the comments of this video below. And please remember to subscribe for new videos that I create on various different development technologies and tutorials and things like that. Thank you for watching. See you next time.